Hey folks, welcome to Fails and Flails. Today in this video, I'm going to be talking about backstories and why they're important for both the players and the game master. Before I get started though, if you're not subscribed, consider subscribing as I put out videos every week on various tabletop topics. And also feel free to leave a like and a comment down below. Now, let's get rolling. Backstories are a great way to really flesh out a character and talk about who they are, what they've been through, and what they plan to do in the future. A backstory is also going to be an excellent piece of information for the game master to use to create plot hooks, tie your character into the story, and even just to create more NPCs. They can range from being as short as "I was raised by wolves" to being multiple page longs talking about the character's various conquests and battles and the many different things that they went on and did before their current story starts. So I'm not going to say one is necessarily better than the other, but definitely a longer backstory is going to flesh out a character more and give the game master a lot more to work with. The fun part about backstories is that they don't actually have to tie in with your class at all. A cleric may have been formerly a street thug who eventually hit rock bottom before being taken in by a temple. A rogue might have been a wealthy nobleman who was disowned or cheated out of their inheritance and was forced to turn to a life of crime. And a fighter may have actually been a traveling performer or musician who decided that they wanted to become one of the heroes that they often sang about or performed in their plays. Your backstory should also fit your level, though. There's been far too many times where a player has given me a long backstory and talking about how they've killed hundreds of demons and fought off waves and waves of mind flayers or other enemies, and I have to remind them that they're at level one, and so the various feats that they've talked about in their backstory are just completely unrealistic. So that is something to keep in mind. You may be a small town hero, but it's unlikely that you've slain hordes and hordes of demons or something even bigger, especially if you're starting out at a low level. When you're working on your backstory, I also recommend talking with both the game master and the other players. The game master's setting for the campaign may give you some inspiration or ideas that you can kind of work into your backstory. If they have, like, maybe a pivotal focus in their campaign, maybe your character has some sort of tie to that. If you're talking with other players, you might have some sort of previous connection with them, whether that was allies or even rivals in the past. Including notable NPCs is also an important part of any good backstory, whether these are rivals or allies. As far as family members go, I know a lot of people tend to just kind of write them out of their backstory, saying that they were killed. And this usually has something to do with either just wanting to go for that edgy character, or they've had a past with a sadistic game master who decides to use family members as future murder victims for plot development. NPCs you mention in your backstory, though, can be much more than just family members or friends. It could also be, like I said, rivals that you have some sort of grudge with. It could just be other people that you know and have connections with. Maybe you usually get information from them. Maybe they're a merchant that you always go to for buying your goods. Anything like that is just going to make more connections that the DM can use to better pull your character into the story. Including goals and loose ends in your backstory is also another great way to help the GM further weave your character's backstory into the overarching theme of the campaign that you're going to play in. This could be goals to better yourself or find some lost object or get revenge, or you might have an unpaid debt to a notable person that you're going to have to pay off at some point. What it really boils down to is the more that you include in your backstory, the more the GM is going to be able to weave your character into the world that they have created, rather than just having it seem like your character gets dropped into this pre-made world that they have no impact on and no real connections to. And in my opinion, that is the best way to play. Nobody really wants to feel like they're just a stranger dropped into the game. They want to feel like what their character has done before and after the game started actually has an impact on the world, because that's going to make it a lot more immersive and just overall more fun. Moving on to the Game Master section of this video, using your players' backstories are a great way to fill in holes for your campaign, add additional story arcs or side quests, anything like that, and just really flesh out the world that you are creating. Like I mentioned earlier, the characters' backstories should have some sort of impact on the campaign that you are playing and the world that you are building. If they have a backstory, you basically just take it, read over it, say, okay, that looks good, but you change nothing about your campaign, then it doesn't really serve much purpose aside from maybe a few notable points. If the best way that you can do it is take information from their backstory and work that into your campaign. The biggest one here is taking notable NPCs from their backstories and just swapping them out for other nameless NPCs that you had already established. It might be if they mention a cult in their backstory, then you can take that cult and replace maybe an existing cult or a group of bandits or some other notable organization with that cult so that PC now has a direct connection with something in your world. The sooner you can get your players' backstories, the better, because that's going to give you more time to prep for your actual world and make any important changes that you might have to. But even if they get to it to you late, that's really not that big of a deal, as long as you haven't said anything major, any important events have happened that would contradict something, you can just go ahead and change it at a later date. Take those loose ends and those goals that they mentioned in their backstory and use those to create quests for your campaign. That may just be a single quest of retrieving a family heirloom that they said they lost. It may be an overarching theme or just an entire story arc of trying to get revenge for the bandits that killed their family. While your players are working on their backstories, you can also suggest some minor changes to it. If they mention that their family was killed by bandits, but they got revenge on those bandits, you could ask them to just take out the latter part where they haven't killed those bandits, and so now you can introduce those bandits as a plot hook, and they have that new goal of defeating those bandits. You could also suggest different changes to a character's backstory, whether that's just to better mesh with the world that you already have built, or if you believe maybe a minor change will make a certain plot hook a lot more interesting or desirable. And again, telling your players the theme or the setting of the campaign beforehand is probably going to help influence the character's backstory that they are going to make, just so that it fits better into everything that you have planned out. That's all I got for this video. I hope it was helpful. If you stuck around this long, and thank you for watching, consider leaving a like and a comment down below. Subscribe if you're not already. I do apologize if my voice is a little bit nasally. I'm kind of coming off a cold, so sorry for that. But thank you for watching, and you have a great day.